Okay. Let's do more Animal Crossing if you're watching this later on YouTube. Thanks for clicking. Hope you've been enjoying so far. Hey. It's been a while. It's after I've moved places, so. Also new computer. I've had to make some very quick adjustments. Some might be noticeable. The audio for one is going to be completely different. The setup I was using in the previous computer, it just doesn't work on Windows 10. I mean Windows 11. I tried to fix it, just couldn't get it working. So I'm running it through OBS. It might be a bit different, but we'll see how we go. But yeah, hopefully everything is normal. Okay. Well, this is nice. Be my watch going off saying, hey, you're live. The good news, I won't have to water anything today. Ooh, it's a thunderstorm. I mean, hang on, I've set up these monitors properly. I guess it won't matter on this. I'm not completely settled, but at least I got the switch up and running. Oh. I don't think I've ever played this game when there's a thunderstorm on. Or maybe I just don't remember it. There's gonna be a lot here. Which I guess is a good thing. Too full. Oh, I have stuff on me. That would explain it. I did try and pick up fossils where I could in my absence. I guess let's get the one. Whoa, that loaded in. Let's get the ones that I have identified. Odds of me finding those fossils are pretty low. Especially if I have three left. TV camera. Hang on, I'm just keeping a check. I guess this is the other thing, is I'm trying a different encoder, so I'm worried about it. I should stress less. Really? That was not that expensive, given what it is. Alright, I need to... Okay. Now I may buy it. I love how it's a third of the price of the camera. Oops. Ah, there's still more. Stop. This is all I did. Just straight up bolt panel, panel, panel. Yoga mat? Rocket statue. Okay. Well, I mean, I think I got both. Here's the thing, I'm almost out of money, so I need to make money. So I will put down panels, but today I might focus on money making. It's a fake! Hey, Messiah, how's it going? I think this one was a fake, too. Good. How am I? Very tired. Still Very tired. Probably the first evening in several days where I've just been able to switch off. Everything gone well? For the most part. Just, yeah, moving sucks. Just at the end of every day, I just feel like my body just goes, oh right, yeah, you're tired, and then it just sort of collapses on itself a little. Because I'm on a new computer, it's just been a mess to get the streaming set up again. There's a couple of things that I don't think I can fix, so I've had to, like, improvise. For starters, the sound. What I had set up for sound, what I was using doesn't work on Windows 11, so I had to redo it doing something else. I'm hoping the sound isn't too much different from before. And then the overlay thing that I do for, like, the intro screen, BRB, and end screen. I guess because when I made it, it's old. It's just, it needs updating. And it just refuses to run. Again, Windows 11. Didn't notice any difference. Good. I spent ages on it. Anyway, the dodgy thing I ended up doing for those screens, I just straight up went on the old computer, recorded them as a VOD, and then I just put them here. So it's like, to most people, you won't know a difference, but I can't add new ones unless I go re-record it. I need to rebuild the thing, but I just don't have time for that. So static video as it is, it'll still be fine. I still got a lot of unpacking to, but in general, I think it's okay. Mario RPG soon. We'll see how we go tonight. I didn't want to start it new, because I just wanted to make sure that stream was okay, audio was fine. And that the VOD that I record, you know, the local copy, is fine as well. If that's all good, then we can look at it. It's using new stuff to record the stuff to Twitch, so I just want to make sure that everything's all good before starting something new and then getting annoyed that it just doesn't look or sound good. I have the game on my desk. I had to look for it. I was like, shit, which box did I put it in? So I had to go through a couple boxes, but it's on my desk now. Aside from that, the new computer's good. I like it. If I could have Windows 10 on it, it'd be perfect. I haven't felt this way about a version of Windows since Windows Vista. Like, the last time Windows just stopped, I had to, like, grab a bunch of different stuff again. That was Windows Vista. I have a new one. Yeah, I mean, that was gonna be the upgrade for the end of the year. I was just waiting for new processors to come out, and they came out, so I got it. So, whilst I don't have the PS5 hooked up yet, it's still in a box. At least now when I do PC games, I can do 1440p, and it's not gonna struggle. It's gonna be just fine. No idea what that means. Extra high quality, crispy picture. When I play the PS5 or computer, you won't notice the difference with Switch stuff. Like, the Switch stuff is just like this. But when I play, like, story-driven games or just stuff on PC, especially if you're watching it on the TV, you'll notice a difference. It'll look nice and clean. Oh, right, I haven't opened the boxes. That's just, like, me in real life right now. Just a ton of boxes that are just sitting here. This new room is much bigger. I don't want to exaggerate, but like, it feels bigger. And I know this because the panels that I put on the wall, I ran out. So there's like, there's definitely more room. There's a bigger area to carry. And the layout is a lot better. We might even be able to put a couch behind me and still be okay. Before, that other room was tiny. More space. Sort of. In some ways, yes. In other ways, no. At the very least for this room, it's definitely a little bit bigger, so that's nice. Dance live. Even if I had the space, that's just not me. I am not the one to stream that stuff. Besides, if I tried to do that now, I feel like I would just pull an old man and like just pull a muscle because I'm still tired. And then I'd be out for like a month. Yeah, that first day I moved, started moving stuff. That day, in my mind, I was like, oh, you know, I won't pack the computer away. I can still do a stream. And then as time progressed, I was like, oh no, I'm most definitely not doing a stream. I think I should just pack stuff away as quick as I can. Also, I was just tired at the end of each day. It's just, could not bring myself to just talk after that. After several hours of moving, there was a drink in the fridge. It was just this orange soda. And it was a bit humid, but once I was done for the day, I grabbed that orange soda, drank it, and it was like the best orange soda I've ever had in my life. Like, those commercials where the dude just slams down a drink, and it's that refreshing, ah! That's what it was. What's so many of these panels? I'm not even sure if I'll have enough. The other thing that's nice as well is just both. Here's the thing. It's more room in terms of the rooms. But like this, where I am now and the bedroom, there's like, it's a better layout. But then, it's, I don't know. There's some parts where it's like, it's definitely less room. But then I guess the trade-off is the actual rooms, like where I'm streaming from in the bedroom, they're better. So I think it's a fair trade-off. And the fact that I have to use stairs now, but eh. I get my leg day now. you need my help with what? That's what I... Is this a joke? What do I call a bear with no teeth? I don't know. This is either gonna be a real thing or it's a joke. A gummy bear? Ah, oh, ha 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 ha, clever. Imagine if it was just like, no, there's a bear here and it doesn't have any teeth. What do I do? I don't know. I've been here for like 10 minutes just customizing. Okay, it's nearly done. Serious question you need help with. What is the capital city of Australia? Canberra. Belt. Bearer. Would you say bra? So. CANBERRA. We say bra. It's the same with most Australian cities. We just have our way of pronouncing it. Like instead of saying Melbourne, we say Melbourne. It sounds like you're doing homework. Quick! What's the capital of Australia? Thank you for the Prime sub. Appreciate it a lot. Our capital city's pretty funny. It only exists because Melbourne and Sydney were arguing that they each wanted to be the capital city, so eventually they just said, let's just make a city between the two, and then we'll call it the capital territory. Stop fighting. Other option, civil war. I mean, so the western part of Australia is its own state, so the entire west side of Australia is a state, and they were going to separate and form their own country, and then I forgot what war it was. I think it was World War I happened, but they had a vote whether or not to do it, and the vote succeeded, and then war broke out, and then they forgot about it, or just decided not to do it afterwards. So it was almost a case like we would have had two countries. That's about the only interesting thing you have here. Well, that and the government deploying soldiers to deal with emus, which, I mean, that's pretty famous, that one. Heard about the Great Emu War. It's funny. There's other things like that in Australian history that are amusing. Like this one's pretty morbid, but we had a prime minister that went swimming, disappeared, so they assumed he drowned. And they started a swimming academy in his name. So I mean, I think it's part of the reason why we learned to swim in school as well, but, you know, in his honor, I just started a place to learn how to swim. Thought it was a joke? No, yeah, I thought it was a joke too. There's another one where, so, before more reliable transport was a thing, they used to use camels in Central Australia, because it's, you know, barren wasteland, no one lives there. And eventually we got cars that are good enough to go there. So, we had imported the camels, because they're not native to Australia. So, you know, we got so many of them. The government at the time was like, alright, what do we do with them? And the idea was, I'll just release them out into the wild in the desert and they probably won't survive. So, not only did the camels survive, but they multiplied. They multiplied, and then what's even funnier is now Australia has some of the most purebred camels in the world and we sell them back to the countries we bought them from. That's a good reaction for that. So we have this camel trade now. When the attitude originally was, fuck it, just release them, they'll probably die. They did not die. Okay, I'm done. I'm done with my, like, trivia stuff. It might come in handy, maybe you go to a trivia night and then stuff on Australia gets asked, and then you'll be like, yeah, man, I'm glad Will told me that story. There's far more interesting stuff in other countries' history. Ours is just... we're not that old of a country. Want an Australian ostrich? Me too. One day. I don't know, just so the thumbnail's different. I don't think I have a rain hat. Yeah, that'll do. I wouldn't even know, like, which is bigger. An ostrich or an emu. I know that it's the same as the whole thing between crocodile and alligator. Just similar family, but not the same. The next emu war is a literal war of emus. Okay, well, this is why I got all these panels, so. You would say emu is bigger, but you've never seen one in real life. I was thinking ostrich is bigger, but I haven't seen one in real life. The same thing, but in reverse. Place this without problems. Okay. Hang on. Come on, surely the game's smart enough to figure this out. Hey, you did it. Okay. That's my multiple days of panel buying. Just to finish that. Whilst I was away. I know this weather makes it really impractical. It's like, who would make a library outside? The ostrich is bigger? Oh, okay. Well, there you go. Kind of figured that would be the case. fine. They're heavy? How heavy do they get? Emus are pretty big birds. They stand up to 17 feet tall and weigh 150. However, ostriches are larger. 9 feet in height and 320 pounds. Wow, that's almost double. No, wait, it is double. I was thinking height, but then, I don't know, crossed wires with the weight. I'm very, very tired still. But I just got one more thing to do at the old place, and that's just like clean up a couple things and then it's done. I got nothing left over there, so. I know I still have more panels. Folding floor lamp? Oh, like the Pixar animation thing. That's all I know that lamp from. I guess I'll look for the ghost thing. Weekend, or this week's Thanksgiving, right? Day is it? Oh, man, I'm just looking forward to this weekend. Just hopefully get the bulk of stuff packed away. Well, it's packed away, like where it should be. And then I can just relax in 2 days. Okay. So the Thursday. Gotcha. Or Friday for me. The only thing we've adopted is just the Black Friday sales, that's about it. Which has now become a thing here. But other than that, yeah. I wonder if I should do something, just as like a nod to it. I still gotta finish Donkey Kong, but kinda got derailed with the move. DK, yeah, and I still got Mario. It's sitting here in front of me. I've been trying not to see any information on it. I know it's an old game, but just been staying away. I think provided this mod is fine and there's no issues and everything sounds good and looks good, then I can start it, I think. I'll check. Well, I gotta check the recording once I do the BRB. That I won't be able to see it until I hit stop recording. I'll check it right away. But man, I'll tell you what, within 5 minutes, Windows 11 annoyed me. I was just like, I guess this is the future. But just how aggressive it is in terms of you using Microsoft stuff, like it's kind of annoying. Had to uninstall a bunch of stuff that I knew I was never going to use, and even then, still sort of there. Annoying as fuck to the future. I think that's it. That's what everyone's doing now, is they don't just give you stuff. It's like you got to sign up to their stuff to be able to use your things. Mind you, Apple, like, say what you will about Mac. Like, I get it. For gaming, it's still a joke. But they don't do any other stuff that Microsoft has been doing lately. Hey, sign into your Microsoft account just to be able to use your computer. Did you know that we have Office 365 and OneDrive? We notice you're not using them. What about Microsoft Edge? Did you know you can chat with Microsoft Teams? We put it in the taskbar for you, so you can just click it and start using it. When you click the start menu, Bing will pop up, and you can start using Bing to search for things instead of your computer. What? Oh. Right. Big Mac or Whopper. Man, I can't say I've had one of those burgers in ages. As a kid, I did like the Big Mac. I don't know if this is a nostalgia thing or it's just a thing as we've progressed, cutting costs, or I don't know. I feel like that stuff tasted better when I was younger. I'm a Big Mac guy. I've had both. I enjoy both. Well, I enjoyed both. I don't really have either now. If I was to go to McDonald's these days, it'd either be like the McChicken, because the McChicken here is basically one giant McNugget, or Quarter Pounder, that's it. But that's when there's no other option. If I'm going fast food, it'll be either something Asian, so like noodles or stir fries or whatever, or chicken. Those, like, I'd say my top picks. Top food, best food. I don't know, there's some cold food that is really good, like, there's a few countries that do spicy cold noodles, and they're good, pretty good. Particularly these ones that they serve on ice, oh man. No, you get hungry. Yeah, that's a common thing here. One way or another, the conversation ends up on food. I will say, just the moving thing. Because like, I cleared the fridge and made sure there wasn't anything that could go to waste in it. but just after moving for multiple days and just being that tired, I wanted to just chill. So I got some KFC and it was like the stars aligned. Just the fries were just freshly made. They were crispy, not soggy. The salt was just the right amount of salt. The chicken came up fresh. Everything, it was like the best KFC can be. And I sat on just this old ass chair eating that box, and I was content. Where did the ghost go? Got some leftover ramen. Oh, let's see, that's good stuff. There's a new ramen place that opened nearby, and I had yuzu infused ramen. It was damn good. Like a chicken ramen, but then yuzu. It's almost like having lemon chicken, but yuzu is its own thing. Okay, if I get hungry, I have some potato chips. I need to go shopping. I haven't restocked the fridge because I'm still in the middle of moving things into their correct rooms, and because I had like a room that was a base of operations, and now everything's more or less where it needs to be. Anyway, give me something new, please. Aww. There's this table I want called the Bistro table. But it just hasn't happened yet. Well, base of operation, it's when I just threw all the boxes into a room. I don't make it sound like a command center. It was just like, okay, I don't want to clutter the whole house. I'm just going to put the boxes in this room for now. Get things back and forth quickly. And then once things are sorted, move things around. The command center. I'm that tired, I've already forgotten where I saw the money tree. I know it's here somewhere. When I enter, the packages say captain on the bridge. Do you like, what's the genre? Like, sci-fi? Space sci-fi? You a fan of space sci-fi? Yeah, sorry, I probably walked past this tree. What? Do they not say that on military ships? I don't know. Well, I don't know either way. I feel like military chips would be those MRI things. Just dehydrated potato starch. Seems like you want my chips. Oh, you would want these chips. The spicy salty jalapeno chili chips. The kettle cooked ones. Jalapeno. I don't know why I keep saying jalapeno. If my mom would be hearing me, she'd be cracking a joke like, "Oh, look at you! You're losing it." Am I having a stroke? Aha! Okay. Great aim. Thanks. Yeah. Okay, that's good. I just spent the past... When did I start? It would have been like the Friday. But from the Thursday, I would have been still in preparation for it. So pretty much since then until now, I just... Every day, whatever little time I had between work and everything, that's what I was doing. And of course, Melbourne decided to get humid. Just constant sweat. Come on. There's only three items left, I imagine. Nope. I feel like there was something else I was gonna do, but I've forgotten. I think I need to go customize a couple more walls. I think I found something interesting though, because I went a bit further out today from where I usually go shop. There's like to a suburb that I haven't really been too much, but I had to go there today. And I don't know if it was just coincidental, but there were a lot of Americans around there. I feel like it's a suburb where there's just a bunch of Americans there. Did not know that. But you know, just, I think after about 20 minutes, I was just like, this seems oddly American around here, why? Yeah, I'm broke. Alright, well, let's get this in. I think I have that one. So... Still need more simple panels. It'd be like 100,000 bells worth of simple panels. Okay. I guess I should deposit the excess. Okay. What is young royal shirt? Oh, okay. Yeah, let me know if you can hear the clicking of my controller. Because, yeah, having to change the audio settings. I spent so long on it, longer than I would like to admit. This is the closest I've felt to like an old man that doesn't know anything about technology. It's just... I know my stuff with computers, but man. Just the amount of things that they just change in Windows 11. Too heavy clicky. Nothing. Okay, good. Accidentally cancelled. Because I know some people really don't like it when you can hear controller sounds through the mic. I had to move my mic because it was too close to the computer. It was picking up the fan. Animal Crossing calls for white knuckle holding on controls. Well, when you have to buy things in bulk, it can happen. Have the same dialogue tree that you have to sit here for 30 minutes just because you want to buy 20 things. Your hearing isn't perfect anymore. Too much loud music. Fair enough. Alright, let me just check what the recipe of the day is. My hearing's still okay. But granted, there are things where it's just like... Definitely from wearing headphones too much. I will say, like, what times with just me moving stuff in the room, it felt like I was just playing Animal Crossing, but in real life, just where furniture was gonna go and just layouts and stuff. Oh. Yeah, why didn't I pick this? I'm still tired, clearly. Yeah, my sleep has not been the greatest the past couple of days. You're not making anything too. Wait, who's making stuff? Oh, thanks. It's no bueno. Yeah, it's alright. I'll make up for it. Let's just... having to get up earlier just so I could squeeze in a couple more trips in the morning. Just to make sure things get done, that's contributed to it. need to pick what I'm gonna do next on the island. I still can't believe the flower thing. All right, Turkey Day. They're talking about it in game. Okay, so then Thursday, right, it should be... I think I need to change the clock. So it's not nighttime here. One thing... I guess in theory I could try. Because it's made me wake up early. It's made me wake up early. I could try getting up early. And try streaming in the morning, so then it's like a better time zone, but... Oh, there we go. Sasha's got it. Cheating? I mean, it's just... I'm keeping it to the same day, it's just... So then the event isn't over by the time I actually get to be able to stream at night. I don't think I'm doing anything highly... Oh, I already got peach jelly. I don't think I'm doing anything highly beneficial. I just wish the time zone was just not as bad as it is now. I'm here. Clever use of game mechanics, what? Changing the time on the Switch? Hey, Mrs. Ham. I have been moving places, so... That's where I've been. I've been... doing a lot of trips. Hopefully to better places. Yeah, I mean, there's parts here that's an upgrade and things that are like smaller. Like, the room that I'm in now is bigger and the layout in the bedroom's better, but then there are other things that I have slightly less room. I don't know. See how I feel. Not that. I think the main thing is... Oh my god. Stop. Focus on what you're doing. No matter how many times I access this menu, every now and then, when I'm tired, my brain just derps. Yeah, moving sucks. But you know, I will probably have to do it again at some point. This apartment stuff... It's fine for now, but eventually I do want to get something more permanent for myself, so... Or whatever whatever situation I may be in the future. You want to go to work, you feel like vomiting just because you're reminding of work. Do I have any other one? Oh yeah, I got telescopes for the thing. There's the other one. The only thing that's annoying right now is, like, I'm sleeping on a couch, a very comfortable couch, mind you, but, like, cut a long story short, I ordered a mattress that was supposed to get here before I moved, so then it would get moved together, but then something happened, just a lot of mess ups. And so it's coming tomorrow, but tonight I gotta sleep on a couch. Because I already got rid of the old mattress, I had to. I wasn't gonna bring the old mattress here and then have it be removed again. It's just, nah. It would have been multiple extra trips. So I was like, alright, I'll just spend one night on the couch, it's fine. The couch I have is super comfortable. Like, I'm pretty tall, but I can fit on that couch just long ways perfectly fine. Holds two people pretty comfortably as well. Do they charge extra for delivering mattresses to apartment? Nah. Though they do say they only go up one flight of stairs at most. Or was it two flights? I can't remember. But I'm fine with that. Okay. I guess let's see what the telescopes can become. What do I want to do color-wise? I mean, maybe blue's fine. Keep blue. At least after the next time I play this, I think I'll be caught up on the simple panel stuff. I'm pretty happy with how the west side of the island is looking now. Given that it would have been like a week ago, it was just a mess. I just need those hybrids. It's just refusing to give me anything. Maybe the thing I missed, because I swear the only thing that needs the gold watering can is the roses, but I might have to double check that. But I've just had no luck when it comes to these or these. It's just, it hasn't given me the green one yet. What color am I trying to make? This one, I believe it's black. That one is green. That's the only color missing. That's the mic. Here I need black as well, I believe. Here I need purple and I guess blue. I've got one blue, but I need more. Tulips, I forget what color. But I only have orange as and pink as a hybrid. How about gold? But I thought rose was only gold. This just needs purple. And then I'm done with that. This needs black. I have purple, but not black. Oh, and blue. Gold, I need the gold watering can, and then I need to isolate the red hybrids. So. Okay, for now. I'll figure out what to do later. But this can just be placeholder. Yeah? Yeah, that's fine. Okay. Is that four or five? I think it's four. I think after the next batch, then I'll have the ability to make another stall. I think that's a fake as well, I can't remember. I'll have to double check. Okay, money rock. I'm just glad that I don't think there's anything major in terms of construction I want to do. Now it's just a matter of building the little things out. The only big thing left is just the flowers. Oh yeah, I need to get seats for here. Also, this needs to get moved down one, because it's in the way. There we go. This looks better when it's not raining. Just right now, when it's raining, it's like, not really practical. Know the sound of self-made floor pavement designs. It sounds like someone squelching meat between their hands. What, when you're stepping on it? To be honest, I haven't been paying attention. The very specific sound as well. I'll go check if that's real. I don't think it is. Oh yeah, right, I have a lighthouse. Cannot be unheard. I had a friend that, when he heard stuff like that, one of his favorite comparisons was just, he would say it was akin to sticking your hand inside a jar of mayonnaise. I'm like, dude, don't say that. Just the mental picture. Like, entire hand. I bet it's fake. Is this fake? Yeah, it's fake. I do find it funny that there's... This game's very wholesome, but there's a character in here who's just out to scam. Or maybe not necessarily out to scam, but it's just dumb. Either smart because sells stuff that's fake, but then also dumb because accidentally sells something that's real. Or, conversely, it's innocent where Red believes that everything is real, but then gets duped into acquiring a lot of fake stuff. I don't know, I feel like either way it doesn't bode well. Ah, I thought that was it. Alright. I'm gonna go hit some rocks. I don't think I'll do any decorating today. I just wanted to catch up, because it's been a few days. There was a stockpile of stuff to do. But also it lets me catch up and just think, okay, well, what am I gonna work on next? I can't believe I picked that first. I mean, maybe I can... The problem is with some of these is I need furniture. Maybe I can start working on... Because I wanted to set up like a flower stall here. As awkward as this might seem, I'll figure it out. And then here, like a communal camp thing. That's like, you know, here. And communal camp thing here. Something that looks more like people would gather around a campfire or something. I need furniture in real life. Aside from a mattress, nah. I'm actually pretty good. Coffee machine? Nah. I don't have a coffee machine. That's not furniture, that's appliances. But, you know, I live in Melbourne. So, let's just go for a walk, go to a local cafe, it's fine. I live in an apartment, I don't have the room for the kind of coffee machine I would want to make my coffees. Maybe one day. Had your friend's dad get you a croissant from Melbourne? Is it from the very famous place? The place where people line up at 5 in the morning just to get a croissant? Yes, yeah. I mean, still would have been amazing. Wait, what am I doing? Oh, she's wearing... What I gifted. What was it called? La Lune. Or the Moon, I think it's called. It's internationally famous. It tasted pretty decent. Pretty normal after traveling that distance, yeah. I mean, for that, it would still probably be fine. That's just... It's piqued my interest, but I just can't bring my... Like, I've said this multiple times. I'm just not a morning person. I think if I was a morning person, I might be... a self-deprecating joke, but like a little more successful on Twitch. That's what it comes down to, honestly, is just... Peak time on Twitch starts at about 5 a.m. Australian time. I can stay up as long as I want, I just can't get up early. I could stay up until 4 a.m. No problem. Getting up at 4 a.m? Uh-uh. Because that's what it would take. I'd have to get up at 4 a.m. Maybe 4:30. Give myself half an hour to kind of wake up. Maybe have something to eat. So then I'm energized. Then stream. And then end stream later because I have to work. Dude would not get up for a croissant. I mean, it's like, yeah. It's one of those things that it's that distinct, it's top of its game. And I think if it was something that if someone wanted to go on that adventure, and they wanted someone to go get one with them, I'd probably do it. But on my own accord, nah. I like a croissant. I like a good croissant. But it's not up there on my list of food items that I would get up at. It would have to be at 4 in the morning to line up at 5. And even then, the line is... I hate lines. The line would be an hour, if not more. And you're not guaranteed to get one either. That was... a special island, at least. Line up for one, no way. You send friend's dad. Friend's dad was nice. See, that's... I like the idea of an amusement park. I like the idea. I just hate lines. When I say I don't want to go to an amusement park, it's got nothing to do with the rides or anything. It's just, man, the lines. Blowing moss dress. I just realized there's an animal called Pancetti. Like, please tell me Pancetti's a pig. I don't know what I was expecting though. I just want this to be a unique island, that's all. I'm glad that, at the very least, nothing has gone wrong stream-wise. it seemed, aside from me having to redo my audio, and the BRB screens and all that crap not working, everything else is fine. Everything else is fine. I'll have to watch my own stream. Which... it's just... I don't know. I get tired of the sound of my own voice. Does anyone ever have that happen? Just... you've heard your own voice, you get tired. Like, oh, I don't like the sound of that voice. Windows 11 happens. I've seen what it can do. Just, oh man, the restarts. You teach? Oh yeah, that would do it. I just... maybe I just don't like hearing my own voice, that's all it is. Is that everything? No, I gotta... I have a voice that I should rent out on Audible. If it paid well. I've said this before, like, it's surreal to hear that. Because growing up, I'll tell you what, like... maybe because it was just... the mix of not speaking English properly, but also just... I guess the Aussie kids that were at our school, but... they did not like the sound of my voice. But then, at a certain point, I don't know when, people started saying that. It's like, oh, you should totally look into reading stuff. Does it not pay well? I would assume not. If you're not famous, I would assume not. I mean, this came at a time before I was a teenager. That's just kids being kids. And also, my voice was like a child's voice. It wasn't what it is now. So maybe whatever my voice was as a kid may have been not great. Hey. Okay, well, one piece of gold. I'm gonna get whatever I can from this island. I remember once I said something in Spanish and then a friend of mine was like, wow, that sounded so good. What did you just say? And all I had said was, where's the bathroom? ¿Dónde está el baño? Probably not in that voice though. I'm doing this because I need normal wood. I'm gonna build more stalls, so let's just get ahead on that. Either I'm unlucky or it's just normal wood is rarer, but I'm always running out. You can say wash your hands. Is that because you learned that, or because you learned that from an episode of American Dad? It was the American Dad episode, wasn't it? I knew it because I've had that happen so much and I just know who it is. It's a pretty good joke, to be honest. Like, it made me laugh pretty good. It's just like with French, omelette du fromage, which apparently doesn't make any sense, but that's, you know, that's what I got from Dexter's lab. Okay, just looking. Oh wait, I can do that one. Thanks to this neat thing. Oh wait, is it shrubs or is it? Ah, I thought it was trees. No, it says plant trees or shrubs. Oh, but fruit trees don't count. Psst. Way to get semantic. It's like, oh no, but a fruit tree isn't a tree. It's a plant that gives fruit. If I would have known earlier, I would have brought something to this island to plant. It's okay. All right, we're done here. Yep. I'm gonna be honest, I went to get water there. If you're wondering why I was quiet. Okay. I know that there's a taller bookshelf thing, but I just haven't found the recipe for it. This looks dumb. It's raining. But yeah, ideally, what would happen would be this would be shut down for the day when it's raining, so then the books don't get wet. I thought this idea was nice, but it looks kind of stupid right now. Just all these pillows and things getting just drenched and, well, the pillows will be fine. This is all, yeah. Just gone. One thing that I will change is this fencing. Because I want it to match this. I'm pretty happy with that little area. Chairs need... I don't know. I want this, but I just need more stuff. You can read fairy smut books outdoors. What do you mean, fairy smut? What is fairy smut? As someone who is not an aficionado of that stuff. I should probably look for the... We'll go sell first, but... There should be two furniture items today, so... That's the newest thing in the book world. I kind of refuse to look it up. I don't want to know. I could live a very comfortable life without knowing that information. All millennials are on fairy books. You try to say all the kids are doing it, it's just... I'm gonna do like the Steve Buscemi thing, just... How do you do, fellow children? I too am reading the fairy smut. I'm leaving it there. I don't read books. I read books, just not the kind of books that are just about fantasy. If I'm gonna consume fantasy, it's visual. In the sense of pictures. Reading for me, I guess, is more of knowledge expanding. As opposed to entertainment. Can't do visual, never lives up to the imagination. Yeah. I can understand that. It's to each their own. I don't know any man who has read fairy books, smut. I almost read that as has not. Like, being debated into reading it. I don't know if I like the yellow lighthouse. Going to go get it customized. It just reminds me of this TV show. And book series, for that matter. It's called Round the Twist here. But all it is just a bunch of strange things that happen to a family that lives in a lighthouse. I should just make it a white lighthouse to make it match that. I didn't realize how old that stuff was. We talk about that Round the Twist thing, like, oh, it's even way before my time. Around the twist, you never heard of that, Mr. Sam, Paul Jennings. It used to be on TV as well. It was on ABC. You hated it, really? The books, the TV show, or both? What? Which one do I want? Maybe I'll go blue. Between blue or red. Red. I went with blue, but it's the reason I went blue was because of the things that I put on the cliff earlier, but I was gonna check them. Maybe I can check them now, hang on. Because if they were a similar blue, it'd be fine. Let me see. Hold on. Kind of remember what it's called. It's like tourist something, right? I'll find it. Where is outdoor? Maybe facility is what it is. Sorry, this is important because it'll save me a trip back to Harv's. There it is. Tourist telescope. Ah. And then hang on. Do we have lighthouse? It's a category for European. Europe gets its own category. And then how does the lighthouse look? I kind of wish there was a better way to preview things. Yeah, I mean, it's hard to tell. I've got to put it back. If I don't like it, I'll come back. I've done that a couple times. Just have to put up with it. I wonder if you could find episodes of those old TV shows on YouTube. Some of them... I don't even know if they would have gotten released to DVD or something, but... I would imagine that they would just be a result of someone having that taped somewhere. That game show I used to watch on TV, I'm surprised there are episodes of that on YouTube. See, right now, because of the sky, it just looks like it's very monochromatic. Which... Ugh. But the thing is, during the day, it might look different. Let me go have a look at... I think I might change it to red, just for contrast. You watch the animal farthing wood in tears. That show was... Man. just very dramatic for a kids show, but there were a lot of kids shows that just had those very serious things happen in them. It was a show that, what, aired in Europe, and for some reason here. It didn't air in America, so. But I guess for the Americans watching, it's like, imagine Captain Planet, where it's trying to teach you something about preservation and conservation of animals, right? But then, you know, Captain Planet, one of the main characters, dies. That's what The Animals of Farthing Wood is. It's like, you follow this story of animals that communicate with one another and talk, and you can understand them. And then it's just stuff happens to them. It's just, you know, whether it be Mother Nature being cruel or just humans being, humans. And they just meet their end. Go Planet? Is that... I feel like that show would have either been remade or it's just still on. I have seen some of the kids shows that, that some of my friends' kids watch, and I don't know, man. Some of them, it's just, they feel like their whole premise is just, let's make a bunch of loud noises. But not in a clever way. Listen, I used to like Pingu. A show whose entire narrative is just Pingu making noises. However, the reason that is done is because then it can be universal. It's just like, you make up the story, and you know what's going on without a single word being done. It's clever. You like Trapdoor? I'm surprised you like Trapdoor, but then you didn't like Round the Twist. Those two shows were pretty similar. The one that I thought was great, that was just animation shorts, it was called Soup Opera. And it was just stop motion animation of just fruits and vegetables with an opera singer in the background. There weren't that many of them made, but they repeated them constantly. And the song is an earworm. Twist had real people, you don't like it? Because it had real people? You don't like people's faces. That must be a struggle. Kids shows still. This feels like a a very Zoolander thing. What is this, a lighthouse for ants? Like, look at this door. I only just realized that's like, well, what's the practicality of this? Anyway, that's looking better. The petrol scene. Yeah, classic. Particularly with the music. And then just the description of it. And they all died in a freak petrol fight. I forgot the words he used, but it was just to describe the whole freak accident. It's like, that wasn't a freak accident. Is there an ant character? I don't think... Yeah. I don't think so. I want to say no. I guess in this universe, insects aren't, human-sized. Excuse me, Brine Shrimp Aquarium? I can't even see- Oh! That was like the whole sea monkeys thing. It's so funny how they just sell kids a bunch of stuff that is so inexpensive to make. And just market it as like being this fancy thing that it's not. Like sea monkeys! And it's just brine shrimp. And then magic sand! It's just normal sand. Well, sciencey sand, but still. Please no Wham music. Not a fan of Wham. Messiah. You're getting ear cramps from it. What do you mean you get ear cramps from Wham? But then... Careless Whisper was on the Wham album, wasn't it? I think. I can't remember. Because it's cringe. I don't think there's anything wrong with liking that song. It's just too much association to Zoolander. I think there's only a small selection of songs that are genuinely like, you cannot seriously be into them. Wham had its popularity in its heyday, and it wasn't because it was a meme. Like, remember the ketchup song? Anyone? Wham is a bit of a joke, how so? Depeche Mode is far more serious, but that's subjective though. Depends on your own tastes. It's not like as a large majority of the population at the time people were saying Wham was a joke. That's not it. That's just like your opinion, man. I'm talking about things where, you know, like Crazy Frog, for example, people knew that was a joke. You can't laugh at Depeche. I can't laugh at Wham. I don't... You're laughing at Wham because of Zoolander. But like, before that movie came out... Wham is camp? I don't think there's anything necessarily wrong with camp. Camp has its place. Like I've shaken everything. You're laughing at Wham because of George Michael. What did George Michael do? Why? That's not what I wanted to do. I guess I'm just looking at it from a not my personal taste sort of thing, but more of a, well, the populace as a whole, how did they view Wham? It wasn't seen as a meme as a vast majority. I don't know. Just spent so much time talking about Wham. Someone out there is going to be like, what the fuck are these old people talking about? Why do they keep referring about the sound effect? What is this Wham? Imagine thinking I'm old. I mean, I'm getting there. I think conceptually old is just... The bar has shifted a little. It used to be a case of just, well, you know, mid-20s, shit, you better be already... with life's big things kind of sorted. I think that has moved by like 10 years now. Personally, I think old starts once you're like in your mid-40s now. Like, 30s are effectively the new 20s, just because of how expensive everything is now. Like, to be able to realistically do anything in your 20s now, best of luck. That being said, in the context of streaming, people do consider I guess it's almost like sport, you know? People in their peak when they're in their 20s, and then beyond that, they're just considered old. It's because of this bridge. Wait, what is going on here? Why was that there? Are you kidding me, fish? Really? Am I having a stroke? What do you mean? Hey! I swear. Yep. Yep. Alright. Great. I love the part where it was unimportant. I may have to play this on the couch and earn some money myself. Hot item, coffee, and book. Okay. So, anyone got anything interesting going on Thursday? I'm phrasing it that way. It's not 100% oriented towards Americans, assuming they're even up at this point. I had to sell, so. Birdhouse and peach jelly. Interesting. Say, if I was living in America and the whole Thanksgiving thing was happening, it'd kind of be the same as how I am at Christmas here. So here, I mean, in our family, it's pretty traditional to do turkey. But every year, there's a battle between, I guess, I'll say my parents' generation. That'll cover it. That want to stick to the tried and true, you know, turkey, and then they do the turkey dinner, and then the next day they have sandwiches. They're called drowned sandwiches. They're actually pretty good. I don't mind the sandwich aspect. But the turkey aspect on Christmas, just... chicken is just superior, man. It just is. You could have a really, really good cooked turkey, but if you put that same level of caliber into chicken, it's always better. That's my view on it. Whereas in, if you mess up turkey, it can become dry. Chicken, you really have to do a number on chicken for it to become as dry as turkey. So, I guess if it was a Thanksgiving thing for me, I would want chicken instead of turkey. You want a big nuggy? So, I mean, I'm not sure. This is just from a couple of people telling me, but the McChicken in America isn't the same as what it is here. So here, It is quite literally a giant McNugget, and then it's just lettuce and mayo. That's what our McChicken is. And it's great. But apparently that's not the case everywhere. Like, they do some other thing. That's peach jelly, right? Yeah. Get two of them out of the way. That actually kind of looks nice. How much of the other fencing do I have? Apparently none. Please tell me it's hardwood. The McChicken sandwich here is a giant nuggy. Okay, so it's the same. I also hate that it's called a sandwich. I'm sorry. I've gone over this discussion several times during my streaming tenure, but like... Okay. Just try and follow the logic on this, okay? Let's say you're someone that absolutely hates sliced bread, right? Sliced bread, specifically sliced bread. So the white bread, the just anything that is sliced bread, you hate it, okay? Let's just set that precedence right away. You just don't like it. It's a reality. Or perhaps you want things in a bun, right? So in Australia, when you order a chicken sandwich, you don't need to, you never ask the question, what kind of bread? You know, when you hear the word chicken sandwich, you know it's going to be sliced bread. When we say chicken burger, you know it's going to be in a bun. The bread is just, you never have to convey it. But then when it comes to beef, right? Okay, so listen. When it comes to beef, if you put a beef patty between two slices of bread, why do you still call it a burger? And if you put it in a bun, it's still called a burger. So what if I specifically want, you know, the first? Think about it. Okay. I'll ask the question. Okay. So I'll say the bread and I'll say the meat and then you tell me what it is. Okay. So sliced bread, beef patty. What do you have? Okay. Burger. Now bun and beef patty. Okay. Chicken and sliced bread. Do you see? It's just... that's... You can take it to a more universal thing, as you know, the age-old debate is hot dog is a sandwich, right? But, so here's the thing here is, if I order a chicken sandwich, I already have a mental picture of what I'm gonna get served. There's no ambiguity ever, because the bread is already determined by the name. So I know exactly what I'm gonna get visually. Beef patty shouldn't be in sliced bread, only bun. Well, apparently in some parts of America, they call it a patty melt, which makes it even more confusing, because then it's just like, okay, so then you have a specific thing for it, but for some reason for chicken sandwich, you don't. It's okay, like, Australia has stupid things, in my opinion, when it comes to naming conventions. Like, we have chips and chips. And we don't ever get confused. So, you know. We don't say fries, we say chips. Because that's just us inheriting stuff from the UK, right? But then we don't say... We say chips for potato chips. We don't say crisps. And yet, if someone's going to the store and I say... Can you bring me a bag of chips? I don't need to say anything further. It's just like, okay, yeah. Clearly you mean potato chips. I don't know, I've always called it both, and I've never had a scenario, and I don't think many Australians have ever been in a scenario where you confuse one with the other. It's just context sensitive. It's rare that you'd be referring to, like, fries and chips. I guess the only scenario would... But then you would say potato chips. I think the key is the word potato. That's how we differentiate it. Oh, it's only worth 600. Oh well. I feel like if I just sold peaches on their own, I would have gotten more. The one thing that Australians are divided on in terms of naming, there's this thing called, how do I describe this? It's like, imagine you took, fuck, how do I describe this? Without, like, using the colloquial term, okay, yeah, you, like a slice of potato, right? You take a slice of a potato. A thin slice that's... Yeah. Just the whole potato thinly sliced, right? You put it in batter and then you fry it. Now... That is one of those things where, depending on where you go in Australia, it's going to be called something different. So, the two big ones is potato cake, which is... Melbourne. Then there's potato scallop. And oh, there's another one. I forget what it is, but there's like five different ways of referring to this thing, and no one can agree to on it, really. It just depends where you're from. The potato scallop makes sense because when you do scallop potatoes in the oven, it's effectively that scalloped potato. It's like a slice of potato, but I guess the reason I disagree with that is just because then it's the confusion. Well, it's not a scalloped potato, because that's its own thing. But I don't like cake either, because it's like, well, it's not a cake either. It's the most accurate thing is potato tempura, like sliced potato tempura. But that's a mouthful, and Australians can't say too many words. It's got to be, like, short and to the point. I don't know. I'm rambling a bit, aren't I? Thank you. Hey, sleepy Nessie, how's it going? Ah, no, what have I done? What's going on? How am I? I am very tired. Sore all over, because I've been moving houses, so... I just got to a point today where I had enough stuff settled in to be able to stream again. So I've been rambling about random stuff. What, food, 80s pop music? Ostriches versus emus. I don't know, the other stuff as well. That looks better. It's consistency. Emus are adorable. They're alright. I've only seen them a couple times. If I was to pick an Australian animal that I would recommend that you need to see, the wallaby, just because tiny kangaroo. And when you feed them, they are pretty adorable. Hey, Colin, how's it going? I mean, there's quokkas as well, because, you know, they've got the photogenic face, and ever since that picture went viral, sure, but... wallabies are... yeah. I like them. How was the move? Very tiring. Still not completely over, I just gotta... do the last cleanup thing. But all the stuff is out, so... I still got stuff everywhere, but... at least, this room has the computer up and running, so... a bunch of issues, all pertaining to Windows 11. So it took a while to get here. I would've streamed yesterday, but then... when I went to set stuff up, it was just one thing after the next that just was not working because Windows 11. So I've had to improvise and change things, like... my BRB screens don't work on Windows 11, I have to fix them, so... instead what I did, I recorded a video of them. So then I can still play them, they're not the real deal, but at least it's like, yeah, they'll do. Until I got time to actually fix them. So, they're still around. And then my sound stuff just straight up did not work. I had to... try and replicate what I had sound-wise just using OBS. So... I think it sounds okay. And... everything... so far from what I've heard seems fine video-wise. I just need to check the local recording that the quality is all good. But it seems to be okay. Good thing I'm computer smart. I mean, yeah, it's just... I haven't felt this way since, man... Windows Vista. It sounds a little louder. But it's good. Louder in a... if I talk louder, I wonder if it'll hurt ears. Okay, I might have to... I don't want to yell because this is the time where people are waking up slash going to sleep, so I don't want to... okay, I'll tell you what. I'm going to count down if you don't want to hear me, but then people are lying down. If you don't want to hear me make a loud noise, just brace yourself slash mute. when I count down from five. So once I say one, there'll be a pause and then I'll do it. Okay. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hey!
How was that?
Hey!
That wasn't even that loud, but that's about as loud as I get. Once I get really angry at something. It was fine? Okay. As long as there was no peeking. Because I had to move the mic to a different spot to where I had it, which I guess it's closer to me now. Because it was too close to the computer case and it was picking up the noises of the fan, so... That was no good. I had to, undo everything. I felt so proud as well because I was being smart this time. I put power boards under the desk. So then all the wiring is neat. There's no cables on the floor, which, yeah, it's great. So I was all proud of what I'd done. It's not, you know, perfect, right? Like, it's still messy. But there's no there's just two cables on the floor. Which is great. Everything else is, like, mounted into the desk, so... I like the idea of cable management, but it's a pain when you need to move something. I guess you need planning, and with the move and everything, I just wasn't about to plan that, but at least the power management is great. It's okay, just nerd stuff, don't worry. Your husband is big in hiding cables. It's definitely a big skill. It requires a lot of patience. Yeah. I'm 50-50 on it. Sometimes I'll do it, other times I won't. Okay. I guess I can talk to villagers. Coffee. That was the other one that I was missing. I keep forgetting. You just want it to work, you don't care about cables. Yeah. The merit, I guess, is it's just it looks neat. And there are advantages to it. But you basically have to dedicate a day to plan that stuff out. Otherwise, yeah. No one is seeing your work computer. Do you have a bunch of icons on your desktop? Like, just files and icons. I am the type of person that hides my desktop icons. You do not see my desktop icons at all. There is nothing on my desktop. That drives you nuts. Interesting. Yeah. No, I would not be able to do it. One thing I did get, as a little, I wouldn't call it a reward, but just, I guess, a necessity, because I noticed that the kettle that I was using, it's a bit on the old side. So I got myself a new kettle, and this one you can boil the water to a specific temperature. You know, the default is just boiling, right? But you can... If you're really particular about your teas, because some of the teas have specific instructions. They're like, the water needs to be this hot. So I can do that now, if I want to. One thing that made me very surprised was when my uncles and cousins visited Australia, but they live in Cali. They were wowed by kettles. It's apparently they're not a thing. Like, you have to, if you want to boil water, you have to do it on a stovetop. But here, it's just this thing, I mean, other places of the world as well, but, you know. It's this thing that you just plug into the wall, you push a button, once you fill it up with water, you push a button, and then it just boils. And it just plugs into the wall. That's it. Yeah, that's what it is. And so, my uncle, he saw that and he was like, holy crap, that's amazing. Why don't we have them in America? And he ended up buying like four of them and took them back. He took a few back. The Amazon. I have no idea. But it's a standard thing, and it's not just in Australia. Like, yeah, I don't know why they haven't made their way to America. But they are standard here. That would be good for parties. It's good for just general day-to-day. It's just called a kettle. It's just an electric kettle. There's nothing fancy like Kmart sells them for 10 bucks. It's just... But it was pretty funny. Just like that bit of culture shock. There's a YouTube channel I watch, the cooking one, and they had guests from the UK, and you know they had to do a, it was a cooking challenge they were doing, and they wanted to boil some water, and just the guy went to get his kettle. He's like, "All right, I'm in America, because you guys for some reason haven't gotten kettles." And they just, like, rip into them, just because... It's like, how has this concept not made it here yet? I don't understand, like... It's not a cultural thing, it's, like, such a convenience item. Very complicated. Not in all ways. And you know, there were movies that would have someone making some tea. Or something. And they would put a kettle on the stove, and that always confused me as a kid, because I was like... The only thing I thought was, oh, how old is this movie? Like, maybe it's from the 40s or something. Again, me as a kid. Just why are they using this thing from the 1940s to boil water? Just get a kettle. $10 at Kmart. Push a button. Fill it up, push a button. Wait for it to boil, you're done. In fact, it turns itself off when the water's boiled. You don't even need to watch it. It's just once it's done, it triggers a switch that turns it off. So you don't have to watch it. You just go check on it later. Stove is faster. How long does it take on the stove? Because most kettles will boil this in like a minute, if not less. American electricity is weak. Okay, here's it. I don't know, it's just... But even still, it's... Let's say it was the case. Let's say the stove boiled it quicker. But you have to watch it. And then there's also the process of turning on your stove and turning it off. This is fill it up, push a button, walk away. Or if you have a kettle like I do, the new one, you can set it to keep the water at that temperature for up to 2 hours if you want. So if you forget, it'll still be at that temperature. The teapot whistles, the kettles make a sound. It's like a click sound. I think some of them even beep nowadays, I don't know. Was something I wasn't expecting, just the culture shock of kettles. This is a problem. When it's raining, there's not really many bugs out, so I can't do too much about it. I wanted to get a couple more Nook Mile things before leaving it, but being very, very tedious. Electric kettles don't... Wait, boil so fast it doesn't need to make a sound. You won't be waiting long. Well, consider this. Every time I go do a BRB, right? And I say I'm making tea. It's usually 3 minutes. But in that time, I also... You know, if I need to go to the bathroom, I go to the bathroom. In that time... The kettle boils and I make my tea. And also have time to do other stuff. That's how good they are. And here I was expecting... Hermit crabs, because they count as bugs. Wait, long underwear? Maybe I could interest you in a lightly used long underwear set. What? Yes, let's buy some clown underwear. I'm interested. Sure. Lightly used underwear. That just sounds like a very bad... I'm gonna say Craigslist just for the understanding. Or just local listing. Facebook Marketplace. Gumtree. There you go. That covers most of it. Pair of underwear lightly used. $20 or next offer. Is that leaving? Aww. I think I might have to give up on the bug thing. I really did try. Oh, you know what I should do? Because there's only a few days of spring left. Like, man. Should make sure my spring bamboo stock is, like, up to scratch. Assuming I can still find it. Maybe I can't. It might be over already. Nope. Okay, cool. Am I ready for Turkey Day in the game? I don't even know what it involves. It's a foreign idea. But yeah, I'll be ready in the sense that I'll be able to experience it because I actually have the computer set up. Okay, let me sell stuff. Then we can do some Donkey Kong. I'm tempted to do Mario RPG, but it's just... I think I need to be in a less tired state. Because I'd imagine that's going to require reading, and I just don't want to do reading. That's the only reason. From a gameplay perspective, I would love to play it. It's just... because I'm streaming it, I have to read. It's looking for ingredients. Oh, okay. I see, they prepare a feast which doesn't involve the turkey. Kind of funny. Just not really what happens in real life, huh? Well, I guess maybe somewhere. Oh, he's the pardon turkey. I see. I forgot about that, to be honest. It's just I get it. It's a tradition. But hearing about it without the explanation out of context, it's like, what do you mean, pardoned? Because outside of that, isn't pardoning just a crime or something was committed, and so, you know, it's just, they're pardoned. It's, forget, I'm gonna waive the fact that, you did this. It has a different connotation, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. Okay, I'm less poor now. Oh, villager. Oh, quickly talk to two more villagers. Oh! I should do this. I completely forgot she was here. Party. Okay, I have to dress for a party. A rose print jacket. Oh man. What kind of party would I be dressing for? I'm gonna say hi to Alice. Sure, I love reading. I read all the time, I just read that now. Plenty of reading. only because this is here right now. Oh, no. What happened? I'm still trying my best to get the flowers, but man. It's been... say it's been 2 months, but maybe it hasn't. Okay, party. We have to wear this. I mean, party. Yeah, I'll do. She knows Dave. Oh boy. Let's see, is this ready for a party? Okay. Hold on, I'm gonna make this easier on myself. Thumbnail for later. Okay. Alright. That'll do it for now. Like I said, I wasn't gonna do much in terms of continuing nice looking stuff, but I wanted to catch up on the things that were piled up, because I haven't touched this in a while. So, next time, we'll do some Happy Home, and I'll give it some more thought as to what the next thing I'm going to work on is, because I think the panels will finish off that area, so. Alright. This is the part now where I say if you were watching this later on YouTube, thanks for sticking around to the end, hope you enjoyed. And if you want to support the channel, easiest way to do so is just click one of the buttons, like the ones that have a thumbs up on them, it helps out a lot. So thank you to those that do that, or you can also watch me play something else if you click one of the other two videos. But yeah, till next time, bye YouTube.